because the same thing can be said about your group, Senator Pimentel, with choosing Congressman Lito Atienza, Representative Lito Atienza, as Senator Pacquiao's running mate. A lot of people were surprised. This was a last minute choice. I can tell you that on this show, Senator Richard Gordon told us that as early as the night before the filing of COCs, someone was talking to him to be Senator Pacquiao's running mate, someone who is very dear to him, someone from your camp. So explain that to us. What was that process?
No, the PDP Laban delegated to Senator Manny Pacquiao the choice for his running mate. Klarong-klaro naman po yun. So whoever is his choice should be respected by the party. And then about Senator Gordon, Senator Manny Pacquiao has many supporters and maybe they approach a lot of people. So the question is, were these authorized emissaries? Were these authorized talks? So maybe people were just taking the initiative to explore the possibility of coming up with many names to be considered as his running mate. Mm-hmm. But the chemistry, I think, is there. They have been friends for a long time. Senator Manny Pacquiao was not yet a prominent person when then Manila Mayor Lito Atienza already supported him. And ito nga yung magandang kwento na narinig ko, which siguro mas maganda ikwento ni Senator Manny Pacquiao, because housing is one of his priority agenda, priority platform of government.
Mm-hmm.
At one time, according to Senator Manny Pacquiao, he availed of the housing program of the city of Manila under then City Mayor Lito Atienza. So napakagandang kwento na mas magandang ikwento siguro ni Senator Manny Pacquiao kasi personal na dinaanan niya po yun.
Balik po tayo sa partido, Senator Coco Pimentel. How far is the party willing to go to protect this tandem?
Yes, this is going to be the tandem. This is going to be the party to the tandem, the ticket which the party will support, because we proclaimed and we nominated and proclaimed Senator Manny Pacquiao as our party presidential candidate.
Mm-mm.
In our September 19 National Assembly. Then we delegated to him that choice for his vice presidential running mate. So nabuo na po.
This is it. I ask you that question because you know how it is. You know how things go in this country. Last minute substitution, someone sliding down, someone giving way. So is that going to be the case as well for this tandem, or are you confident that this partnership will hold?
No, when we filed this, there's no other plan. At the time when we filed this, there was no other plan. So if there should be developments after the filing, then we did not consider this when we filed, when they filed their COCs.
Mm.
So yan na po yun. But you know, we should be open-minded then. If something better should come up, then we should grab it. But right now, this is the best combination.
Ano po yung something better? How would you quantify that?
I do not know. Kaya nga, you know, iba-iba kasing combination, permutations in politics, to combine Mr. X, Miss Y, ganun. So we do not know yet. But at the time when we filed the first day, that was the plan. There is no other plan.
Would you consider yourself as anti-administration, part of the true opposition, Senator?
Yes, right now, yes. Yes, the Senator Manny Pacquiao will be espousing a reform agenda, and then the priorities would be far from the priorities of the current administration.
Will one of the priorities as well be to hold this administration to account?
Yes, especially in terms of corruption. Sinabi po ni Senator Manny Pacquiao yun. Pag may ebidensya, talagang ipakukulong niya po.
All right. Now, it has been said that these are early days, Senator Pimentel. Some say the situation remains fluid. You yourself said that just a few seconds ago. But others also say that your party is in disarray. So what would you tell us now to push the idea that it is the former and not the latter when it comes to your wing of the party?
When it comes to my party, those who have remained with us, we are not in disarray. But if you, because there's another group bringing the name of the party, then I can understand when people will think that we are in disarray, that bigger body. But the PDP Laban, the real PDP Laban, is not in disarray. We're very clear. So actually, we did all of the, we did even all of the resolutions that need to be passed. We passed. We took all the steps necessary under our constitution. We took them. And then it is the Kusi group which is in disarray because they took the time to publicly hold events, ask maybe the news media to cover them, and then all of what happened there, they did not execute. So that is probably contributing to this notion or to this perception that somebody, some group is in disarray, but it's not our group. It is somebody else's group.
And that all of those things that you just mentioned happened with the approval of President Rodrigo Duterte. What does that tell you about him, Senator?
Well, this is water under the bridge already. So that's for them to sort out, you know. So they should coordinate with their members, with each other. If you claim to be a political party, you consult and you coordinate. That's all I can say. Which what we do. Which is what we do. We really have to spend time, you know, consulting people, calling people before making decisions, calling for a meeting, writing down the resolution to be adopted. So this is how you run a real political party. It takes time. It takes coordination. So especially PDP Laban, which believes in participatory and consultative democracy.
Once again, I have to ask you, Senator Pimentel, because it's quite obvious that you're sparing the president from your commentaries. Why is that?
Because the controversy in PDP Laban is the brainchild of Secretary Kusi. So we have to hold Secretary Kusi responsible for everything which has happened to PDP Laban. But of course, we will survive this because of our unity with the longtime members of the party. So the president, let him take care of the problems of the nation. I mean, I'm sure hindi naman niya to, yung mga maneuvers na ito, yung idea na ito, hindi galing sa kanya, yung pagpapatakbo sa kanya bilang vice president, hindi nang galing sa kanya, hindi na nga niya tinuloy so far. So all of this, everything can be traced back to Secretary Kusi.
Mm. Now, what do you say then, finally, Mr. Senator, to those who say wala naman ho kayong pinagkaiba, whether you talk about the Kusi faction or your faction together with Senator Manny Pacquiao, that it's all the same, that it's all about retaining power, that it's all about not holding to account the president later on?
Yung PDP Laban po, the real PDP Laban, is participating in elections so that we will win the elections and implement our program of government. It's not about holding on to power, just having power, exculpating people from responsibility. Hindi po yun. It's a program of government that we will execute, we will implement. And of course, rule of law will always be there. And if crimes have been committed, especially corrupt acts have been committed, then people should be punished. Klarong-klaro po yan, sinasabi po ni Senator Manny Pacquiao yan.
Right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Senator Coco Pimentel, glad that your internet connection there held up.
Yes, thank you. I'm sorry about the connection. Beyond my control. Thank you.
Senator Coco Pimentel, then chairman of PDP Laban, joining us this afternoon.